Hello there. It's Stuart again. I'm Stuart from the Coda Music Trust, and this is a series of videos featuring some old tunes that hopefully will help you bring back memories and start some conversations. Now, I've got a number of gramophones, and behind me is my trusty workhorse. That's my HMV 108. Now, I'm going to wind it up. And we've got to start putting a new needle in, because you need a new needle per record. And we're ready for our first disc, another disc. And this one is one of my favourites. This is on the MGM label, and it's Jimmy Durante, and I'm the guy who found the lost chord. Now, I found this in a car boot sale, and I have to tell you, I couldn't get my hand in my pocket quick enough to pay the pound to get this record, because it's a great record. And I think when you hear it, you'll instantly recognise him, even if you don't remember the name. Even Morecambe and Wise used to do impressions of this chap, Jimmy Durante. So have a listen, and while it's playing, I'll put up some photos and facts about him on the screen for you. Okay, enjoy.
Sitting at my piano the other day, my mind was ill at ease. They were coming to take it away that afternoon. I was all by myself in a mellow mood, improvising symphonies. My right hand was playing Mozart's Minuet, and at the same time, my left hand was playing Have a Banana from Carmen, and at the same time, my mouth was whistling a sextet from Luigini. And while all this was going on, what do you think my foot was doing? Well, keeping time, it was cracking walnuts. You see, I had to eat too. Then in the midst of my soliloquy, a strange feeling came over me. My right hand stopped playing, my left hand stopped playing, my mouth stopped whistling, and my foot stopped cracking walnuts. Food became secondary. Why? Because, ladies and gentlemen, I found it. The lost chord. That's it, the lost chord. So let's celebrate. I'm feeling great. I'm the guy who found the lost chord. That's it, it hasn't changed. I'll have my name in the Hall of Fame, 'cause I went and found the lost chord. Now everyone knows Tchaikovsky wasn't recognized for 200 years. Brahms wasn't recognized for 300 years. Beethoven wasn't recognized for 400 years. But I can't wait that long. I've got only 2 changes of clothes. So let's celebrate. I'm feeling great. I'm the guy who found the lost chord. How I struggled. I worked my brain to the bone. First I put an A-flat with a B minor. Then I put a B minor with an F major. Then I put an F major with a B minor. Then I tried an A and a B and a B and a G and a G and an E and an E and a D and a B and a G and a G and an E and a B and a G and a B and a G and a B. What kind of a piano is this? No apostrophe. People said I was mad. But that didn't discourage me. They said Mozart was mad. They said Puccini was mad. They said Louis was mad.
Who's Louis?
My uncle, he was mad. Soon my efforts bore fruit and I found it. The lost chord. Music lover, do you realize what you're hearing? I'll play it again. That's not the chord. Neither is that. Neither is that. Neither is that. What happened to it? I've lost the chord. A catastrophe. Lock the doors. Nobody leaves the place until I find it. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to sit down on the keyboard of this piano until the chord is returned. That's it. The lost chord. I found it by sitting on the piano keyboard. Very strange. I usually play by ear. So let's celebrate. I'm feeling great. I'm the guy that found the Lord.
Oh dear, I hope you enjoyed that. That was really funny. Now I bet you've seen a film that Jimmy Durante has starred in, because there's loads, and one I particularly admire and I enjoy is an old film called It's a Mad, 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 Mad World. And in that film he starred alongside people like Phil Silvers, Sergeant Bilko, and the late great Terry Thomas. And if you watch that film, there's loads of legends in that. Anyway, I'm still trying to work out that lost chord, so I better get back to my piano and see if I can find it, because I don't think I can find it. Anyway, so take care, stay safe, and I'll see you again very soon. I'll be back up in the attic and I'll be looking through my 78s and find something interesting that will bring back some memories and start conversations. Take care. I'll see you again.